I take you down, would you really hold me down and be your best friend? She just wanna hit me with a quickie by the pool, and I'm like, yes, ma'am.
Hey! Hey, what's up, guys? It's Juliana Palencia, aka JeweJeweBee. And also, I have a fitness page now called Juju Fitness. So today, I'm going to be sharing with you guys my morning routine. Usually, my morning is dedicated to fitness, getting my workout in, eating healthy, planning my day, all that stuff. So I'm going to be showing you guys that today. I'm currently in my pajamas right now, so I'm going to get changed into my workout outfit right quick, and then I'll be right back. I'm your sweetie pie, wearing your favorite shirt. You're my apple juice. When I wake up, I want you. Even when I'm sick, even when I'm sad and blue. So now that I'm all dressed, I'm going to eat. I'm going to be having a Daily Harvest Oat Bowl. These are super convenient to make, and I have a bunch of different options to choose from. And it's also perfect because I like to track my macros. This has all of the ingredients on the cup, so it makes it super easy to track, super convenient to make. And I get to have something yummy every single day. All I have to do is take this out the freezer, add a half a cup of milk of my choice, and then pop it in the microwave for 2 to 3 minutes. So if you're interested in trying out Daily Harvest, you can use my code JP25 for $25 off, and I'll leave the link down in the description box below. Make sure you check it out. And I'm hungry, so I'm about to eat. It's only been like 3 minutes and I'm almost done because this is so yummy. So I'm gonna finish up here and then I'm going to meet you guys at the gym. So to start my workout, I always start with glute activation. And pretty much what glute activation does is it tells your glutes you're gonna be working today. Because most of us sit on our butts all day, what can happen is when we do glute exercises, if we don't do glute activation first, our quads and other muscles like our back can take over. So make sure you always do glute activation before your workout. I always like to start off with some body weight squats just to get my lower body warmed up. And then I love doing donkey kicks. This is one of my favorite glute activation exercises because I feel this in my glutes the most, especially when I add a cotton band here and I make sure I pause and squeeze at the top. I get a really nice glute burn. Next, I'm doing lying lateral leg raises, and this really targets the sides of my glutes. When I do glute activation, I'm not trying to sweat or get a full workout. I'm just trying to do enough to get my glutes activated. After I'm done these three exercises, I take around a 1 minute rest and I repeat it one more time, and then my glutes are ready to go. So before I get into really heavy compound lifts, I start with a body weight or a lighter weight version of the exercise. So here I'm doing 10 reps of body weight hip thrust just to warm myself up. And then I take around a 10 second break and then go into single leg hip thrust. I do 10 reps each side, and this burns the glutes so much. This is one of my favorite glute exercises. I know it looks really easy, but it is so tough, and you will really feel it in your glutes after you're done. So the first main exercise is going to be hip thrust, and I'm doing 5 sets, 8 reps each, and I'm using 205 pounds. So my glutes were on fire. When I do these, I make sure I pause at the top, and by like the 5th, 6th rep, guys, you'll see in my face, I was kind of done with these, but these are one of my favorite glute exercises ever. So my next exercise are sumo deadlifts, which are one of my favorite but hardest exercises. I cannot explain how this feels, but it feels like I've been running for an hour straight only after doing 10 reps. So I'm doing 4 sets, 10 reps each, and I'm using 155 pounds here. However, when I first started out, I did 20 pound squats, 20 pound deadlifts, 20 pound hip thrusts, because that weight was actually challenging for me. Now, because I've been working out for 2 years, I use a higher weight because I've kind of outgrown the lighter weight that I used before. But as you can see, like, this is a super tough exercise, and whatever weight you use, I guarantee you, you will feel a burn. So this is a superset. So right after the sumo deadlifts, I jump straight into barbell squats, and I'm doing 10 reps here. I'm using a 30 pound barbell, and guys, by the time I was done, my glutes were on fire. Like, I swear my booty got bigger by the end of this workout. You guys let me know, but I swear my booty got bigger. So the next exercise I'm gonna do is a stiff leg deadlift, and this is probably one of my most challenging exercises. I feel like I haven't really fully mastered this, but I try to just do the best that I can and not give up, because that's not gonna really make me improve. So I'm using a 70 pound barbell, and I feel these mostly in my hamstrings, and I personally love a nice hamstring curve because it looks so good going into the booty. You know, you just have all those curves in the back. So don't forget to work out your legs too, ladies. So next I'm going to be doing cable kickbacks. This is one of my favorite, I keep saying that. I guess this is a whole workout of all of my favorite glute exercises. There we go. And I'm doing 20 reps each leg. I'm using 10 pounds here, and I make sure that I squeeze my glutes at the top. My booty was on fire by the end of these. I did 3 sets and I did 20 reps each leg. And I feel like I'm not imagining this, but my glutes are bigger than they were at the beginning of this workout. Like, the glute pump is real, y'all. So the very last exercise are these leg raises, and I cannot do anything after this. My glutes were done, and I was just ready to end this workout. Like, this was such an amazing workout. If you try it, let me know, and I'm gonna finish this up and go home and eat. So I'm back from the gym. So now that I'm home for my post-workout meal, I'm going to be eating a daily harvest bowl. So this is a sweet potato and wild rice hash bowl, and it has tomato, wild rice, sweet potato, great northern bean, avocado. So I'm just gonna warm this up in the microwave for 4 to 5 minutes, and then I'm gonna eat because I'm starving.
Oh no!
So I'm gonna finish this up so I can fuel those gains. Then I'm gonna hop in the shower and get the rest of my day going. If you enjoyed this video, then please give it a thumbs up, and let me know down in the comments what you think of this video, because I've never done anything like this. And I wanna know what you guys think and any tips you have, and also any video suggestions that you guys have as well. Don't forget, you can use my code JP25 for $25 off your first box. I really appreciate you guys for watching my video. It means so much to me. I love your support, and I really appreciate you guys so much. I hope you guys have a great day and a great week, and I'll see you guys later. Bye.